Hi, it's Oink. Today I'm going to show you how to get mining in a Macintosh, how to run a miner on Mac OS. We had some questions. There are a couple of things I need to show you. First, I presume you already have VerusCoin Agama running like I have here. I created one with a brand new wallet. It is fully synchronized. So we'll need that because we'll need an address to mine to, or else you're going to mine to someone else, and that's not the point of mining, is it? And second of all, we will need a miner. Oh, that's the wrong one. Oh boy, I hate. Right. Second of all, we need a miner. I opened the website on veruscoin.io. And I'm going to get VRSC, get VerusCoin. And there are a couple of ways you can get VerusCoin. You can buy it, of course, on an exchange, but you can also mine it. A list of exchanges we have here on the website, and a list of various miners for various operating systems. Now, I am specifically interested in Mac OS. First, we're going to download the miner. I already did that. I've got my miner in my Finder, in my download section, and here you see it downloaded. So, what do you need to do to get mining? First of all, you will need to extract the tar. And that's done by simply double-clicking it. You see it extracting here, archive utility, and it creates a folder, NHAQ miner. Open that one and you'll see a couple of files. Basically, you got some libraries, you got a README, you can read it if you like. I would suggest you read it. You got an NHAQ miner, which is the program itself, and you got a start.sh script. Well, let's see what happens if I double click start. It doesn't start. It opens up the script file to read it, and what we see here is we got a pool host, port, public VerusCoin address, worker name, threads, and they're all empty. They're not defined yet. What we'll need to do is fill those. Now, how do I get that information? That information is listed below the download section, and you got a couple of pools to choose from. What we can do, I'll simply take the first one, not because of any particular reason other than that it is the VerusCoin community pool, and it has a high fee, 5%, but it goes directly to the VerusCoin Foundation to enable them to do more research, more development. Okay, it gives me information. It gives me information for a CC miner and for an NHEQ miner. Well, if I remember correctly, we got NHEQ miner. So what we have here is the host is pool.veruscoin.io:9999. And the 9999 is the port number. We have to put it in separately. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to simply put it in here, viruscoin.io, and the port 9999. Now I'll need a public VerusCoin address. Normally I would say we get it from VerusCoin. And you see I have no transactions at all, but I do have two addresses. If you click on the receive button, you go to addresses. Now, it doesn't show it completely. How do I copy that? Well, that's basically fairly simple. You click on the three vertical dots and you get a submenu. And it simply says copy pub address. It tells you that it has copied it. So I'm going back to my text file. And I'm going to put it in there. Right. I accidentally put in a new line there. So now it has my address in here, and I always verify that thoroughly. That looks to be the same address. Okay, a worker name. This setting is not strictly speaking necessary, but I am going to put it in anyway. I'm gonna call it Mac OS, so I know if I look on the pool later on, it is the Mac OS. Threats. Threats is something specific. As some of you may know, some of you may not know, every processor has a certain amount of cores. And with more and more processors, most of them have also a certain amount of virtual cores, which is usually double the amount of physical cores. Since this is a demo, I'm only going to put one in. There's one thing to keep in mind. If you put in the full amount of cores, your Macintosh may become sluggish or even unresponsive. Always leave at least one thread free for the operating system to function. Now, this is basically all that we need to put in. So we simply save and close it. It is saved. Maybe we should check that just to make sure it's in there. Double click it again. Yep, all the data is there, so it did save. Better save than sorry. Now, how do I start it? You see, if I double click it, it opens up in a textpad, which is standard behavior for Mac. So what I'm going to do, I can do two things. I can rename it like this, or I can make a new file with the same exact contents. I am going to copy this. Where is the copy start sh? And I'm going to paste that item. And then I'm going to rename. And I'm going to call it start dot command. Are you sure you want to change? Yes, I am sure. Use dot command. And when I double click it right now, it starts mining. And it's mining away at the moment. On one core, it is on my virtual machine, so I probably will not get very much of it. But it is mining away. How do we check if it's actually mining? Well, we go to the pool in Safari, and I have here the Verus community pool open because we went there for the information, and I'm going to look at the pool stats first. And it says 5 miners, 9 workers, etc., etc., and it found some blocks, but I still can't see myself here. I didn't find anything yet. I can't find myself. How do I find myself? You go to worker stats, and there it should, after a certain period of time, because it only registers when you have successfully admitted a block. So I'm gonna check it open. Has it admitted yet? Doesn't say yet. But it is mining, and it is mining at a very, 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 very low speed right now. As I said, it is a virtual machine I'm working in right now. However, once it has submitted the block, your address, which it shows here, will show up in this list. Let me check if it's not. R-U-H, it's not in there. Okay, I'll go to my normal miner, this one, and I'll show you what it looks like. You see I've got 4 machines mining at the moment with my own address. It shows you that name which identifies you. And I'm going to go back to my Finder. I'm going to what it says here, worker name, Mac OS, that is represented in those titles. So I got one called A109700E, F1 Mini, RK3399, and Ryzen 2600. And it shows you a nice graph how fast it is going. This is actually proof that you are mining to that pool. Well, that's basically all there is to it. If you want to start your miner on a macOS, all you need to do is open up your Finder and double click that start.command. That's all, folks. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next time.